Hey, Doc Mo here with a test live stream. We're going to do a little bit of Dr. Racket. Okay, here we go. So let's see if we can get started. So, require picturing programs. We're beginning student with list abbreviations. That's good. And our plan for right now is we are going to see if we can write a function to convert a single digit number to its to a word form. And then we're going to apply that to a multi digit number to read it digit by digit. For example, the say digit function is going to take in a number and put out a string. And so usually we're going to say the digit, and we're going to just for so we can write some checks, we'll just have it return 0. And now what I expect is that say digit 1 will put out 1, and so on. So let's get a couple of these. So maybe say digit 9 will produce 9, and say digit 2 will produce a 2. And I guess honestly, we should have a test for state say digit 0 that we already have. We already get the right answer for this one, but there we go. So that's say digit. And so that's a function that I think you can write. And we've talked about it. It's kind of like you could use a method like the method of the method we used in the color code. You could use a list of answers. I think that would be a good way to do it. And now, so anyway, then we're going to write say digits. And say digits is supposed to work with any number. Say digits takes in a number and puts out a string. And the purpose here is take any number and say it digit by digit and put hyphens in between each digit. And I suppose so. I know. So we don't expect to say 10. We expect to say 3, 5. So check expect say digits 35. We'll say 3, 5. And then honestly, we should make sure that say digits by itself will produce the 5, and then you should have a sequence of test cases that worked your way up. So say digits 1, 3, 5 should produce 1, 3, 5. Okay, and so I guess to go back, I want to make to clarify this. The purpose for say digit is give an English word form for a single digit 0 through 9. Okay, so these are the two functions that I think you should practice writing. So tomorrow I'll come back and I'll explain how to do these.